provided to the Daily Record and/or the Star Ledger of Morris County has been delivered to the township clerk and has been posted on the bulletin board of the Board of Education at each of the school buildings in the district. Roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Here.
Mrs. DeLuna?
Here.
Mr. Moore?
Yo.
Mr. Cass?
Here.
Mrs. Wagner? Mr. Kim? Mr. Anderson?
Here.
Mr. Lou, would you mind putting this to executive session?
Certainly. I'd like to move to convene an executive session in accordance with Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act. The purpose of this closed session will be to discuss negotiations, legal, personnel, and security issues. Minutes of the session will be made available to the public. The need for confidentiality no longer exists.
Section. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any ayes? None. Any abstentions? None. We're in executive session as of 7:01 p.m.
Okay. Can I request that on the template we add security to the negotiation, legal, and personnel issues? I mean, we do it enough. Is that something we want to be part of the regular statement that we do?
We can add it.
Only problem is I think it's actually in policy. We have to see if it's just the order of the meeting or that actual wording.
Well, he's asking for the word.
Yeah. I think I should find that.
You read my report, right, on the this HIV case? Anybody have questions about it? It was pretty clear cut.
We're in executive session, right? Should we leave?
Oh, yes, or you have to go. Take the.
Yep.
Keep an advocate alive.
Letting them tell you all about the programs, and then we have a little video at the end.
So, what do you want to stand up?
Yeah. If I stand up, and Mr. Ryan, welcome. This way. Thank you, first round.
Can I come up?
Come up.
Good evening, Mr. Forte and Board of Education members. I am Nate Tecchio. I am a Lakeview Lion leader and volunteer during kindergarten recess. We are here tonight to talk to you about the amazing program we have at Lakeview. Students in fourth and fifth grade have the opportunity to volunteer for the following programs. Lakeview Lion Leaders, Kindness Crew, Start With Hello, Kindergarten Recess Helpers, Morning Meeting Leaders, and all fifth graders run down meetings.
Hello, my name is Brody Halleck, and I'm a Lakeview YM leader. Lakeview YM leader is a peer mentoring program in its fourth year at Lakeview School. Almost 150 students in fourth and fifth grades are trained each year to support students weekly in the classroom and at lunch and at recess. After training, we can also volunteer during our recess time. We are trained in conflict resolution, communication, conversation, and problem solving skills. The mentoring experience helps us as Lakeview YM leaders gain self-confidence and leadership skills.
Hi, I am Owen Bartoya. I'm a Lakeview YM leader and I volunteer for Kindness Crew. Kindness Crew meets during our recess time. Our goals are to create a culture of kindness by working on various projects such as Mix It Up Day at Lunch, Start With Hello programming, Teacher Appreciation Week, making inspirational posters, help students on academic posters, projects, or homework, create bulletin boards displaying pride, and providing feedback on character education programming.
Hi, I am Jake Coughlin. I'm a Lakeview YM leader and I am Start With Hello ambassador. Students in grades 3 to 5 are able to volunteer as a Start With Hello ambassador, welcoming students to school each morning. During Start With Hello week, every student and staff member participated in Hay Day community building assemblies. All students grades 3 to 5 received programming from Sandy Hook Promise on the importance of inclusiveness and community in reducing school violence.
Hi, I am Cindy Fong. I am a Lakeview YM leader and I am a kindergarten recess helper. Each day, fifth grade kindergarten recess helpers teach games, model social skills of good sportsmanship and pride, as they learn skills of conflict, resolution, and leadership. We also run a shoe tying station to teach the kindergartners how to tie their shoes. Kindergarten Helpers is a voluntary program where nearly 80% of fifth grade students give up their recess to mentor, teach, and learn with kindergarten.
Hi, I'm Ashley. I'm a Lakeview YM leader and I'm morning meeting leader. Any fourth or fifth grade student is welcome to join the morning meeting leaders where students plan, develop, and then run morning meetings in preschool through second grade classrooms. Our program is helping to create a greater sense of community across grade levels.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie Camprelli. I'm a Lakeview YM leader and I'm a den meeting leader. To continue with the goal of building a greater sense of community, we now have quarterly school-wide den meetings. A den consists of one class from every grade level. They break up into small morning meeting groups led by the fifth grade students. Every fifth grade student leads a group building leadership and communication skills.
Hi, I'm Jack Bertram. I am a Lakeview YM leader and I'm going to tell you about #AllLakeviewPride. At Lakeview School, we pride ourselves in demonstrating our core values of perseverance, respect, integrity, diversity, and excellence. This year, we have been running an amazing program, #AllLakeviewPride. Students are nominated for demonstrating our core values and will receive a paw. It is then their responsibility to pass the paw onto someone else that is demonstrating one of our core values. We spoke to you about our programs, and now we would like to show you them in action with a short video. Please enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
please join. Yeah, we'd love a picture.
Can I suggest we have all the kids take a step forward and then all the adults get behind?
That's a great suggestion.
Thank God for the engineers.
Am I in your way?
Tweeting that one out.
Excellent, good, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Lakeview students and staff for coming here. I can tell you from my point of view, when I see this program, I couldn't be more impressed. I told the counselors and the principal, the vice principal, it's almost palpable in the building, right? That got Lakeview pride was a great catchphrase that really worked. I don't know if anybody caught it, but before, when Tim was having a hard time getting over here, somebody moved this for him. So I was like, wow, perfect timing, right? We're talking about how you help people and they're going to help them. So thank you for coming out. We appreciate it. Lion, you can give us a roar before you go? No, roar. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much for coming. Really appreciate it. And thank you for the staff and students. Like I said, student run kind of program, and I will tell you, having kids at Lakeview, it means a lot to them, so I appreciate it. Thank you for the parents for coming out and supporting. Keep up the good work, kids. We really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
You guys are going to stay for the whole board meeting.
Everything's all up there. The floor has been redone, and the gym looks great. They were using it today. I went up there to see some basketball tryouts. The vegetables are moving along, but it is going to take some time. We're looking more like in December now, just due to the fact that the materials haven't been on site yet. We have some of the materials, but not all. We need all the materials before we complete the project. CUSAC update. Those of you that know what CUSAC is, it's the state monitor, and Mr. Kim is our board liaison to the CUSAC committee. We have meeting number 6 coming up, and our state monitors will be on site on January 7, 2019, for the whole day. So we had our email monitoring system that we have to see, to catch if somebody's searching for things that would lead us to believe it's a self-harm or harm to others. And we ran a test, but we actually had a real incident during the day where I got the call within eight minutes from the time the search was conducted. I was already on the phone with the principal. So I got called. I was actually doing a presentation at the Chiefs of Police Association. And by the time, only eight minutes went by from the time the student Googled it to the time we already were on it. I just thought that would be interesting to you guys to know. The Value Athletics began this week. We had our boys and girls basketball tryouts started and wrestling team started. Another thing that we started last year, we're continuing, is the flu shots for our staff that we did in cooperation with Walgreens. This year, 44 staff members received a flu shot, and we're going to try to continue to grow that program. The district calendar for 1920 is on for approval on the 26th of November. It's in your shared folder. It was something that was made between all five school districts that make up the Morris Hills regional area. So we all worked on it together. We're pretty close. It's not exact. It's pretty close to what the other districts are. We will be the only ones that are going to give that Friday before Memorial Day. And I explained to them why we wanted to do it. And I still think it's a good idea that Mike came up with, so I support that. And we'll have it on for an agenda on the 26th. I think that I may be able to have the 2021 calendar on the agenda for December. We'd like to put out 2 years' calendars. And we also did those with the Morris Hills Regional Districts, but it might not happen until January. We're going to see whether or not we're going to do it December or January. Again, that would be for 2021. And we're excited to kick off our fifth year of Hour of Code activities. Our Hour of Code has become a pretty big thing around here, and it will be the week of December 3rd through 7th. Mr. Scala spearheads that, and he will be putting out, he will be giving me an agenda of things that we're going to do. We have all kinds of guest speakers, and we do it in cooperation with Morris Hills Regional. They sent some students down to help our kids on our coding activities. So we'll get all that information out to the board and into the public. That's my comments for today.
I have a quick question on the flu shots.
Yes.
Probably many of the staff got their flu shot out of their own private position.
Right. This is just something we're trying to grow, and it's a convenience.
Do we know how many people have knocked out? Like
no, I can't ask that. I can only tell you that 44 people took advantage of the program at Cabot Valley.
Forte,
I have a question.
Sure, go
about the calendar. You said that we're the only ones that give May 26th.
The Friday before Memorial Day. 22nd.
Okay, well, the Friday before Memorial Day. Which additional day do we have that the other districts don't to compensate for that?
So some of them have an extra Jewish holiday. Some of them don't take off for Martin Luther King Day. That's why I said we're close, but not exact.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them use Martin Luther King Day as a professional development day. Some have the second. So depending on the contract, like Morris Hills Regional only has two PD days in their contract. We have three, so it's never going to be exact.
No, I was just wondering what the if there was a like everybody else did one thing and we're doing a different one.
I know the high school does the second day of the Rosh Hashanah.
Thank you. Dr. Cole, is any assistant superintendent comments?
Just one additional comment to Mr. Fortes. Battle of Books is underway at the middle school, so our 6th, 7th, and 8th graders are now getting in their teams and starting their books. So families at home should be asking their students about it because we are underway. Assistant superintendent's report.
Damaris, any business administrator comments?
Just one. I'm just reminding everybody that the budget calendar is by the time of the year again. It's up for approval for the action item. I apologize that we had this last month in October and I missed it. And that's why it's for action for tonight.
7:57, and I will open for our first public comment section. Seeing no one, I will close our open public comment section at 7:57 and move on to the agenda. Mr. Cass, would you mind moving us through old business, no action to be taken?
I'll be glad to. At the next meeting, either myself or somebody else will be moving the following items on our, with our education reports, our Treasury School Monies report, Board Secretary reports, the Nursing Services Plan for the 2018-2019 calendar year, and the District USAC exam team. Noted as below all the people that are involved with that. And also the minutes from our work session October 8th and the regular session meeting executive session of October 22nd. Between the 23rd and November 23rd and February 1st, is that, are they going to be on?
I'll be honest with you, other than what's on there, I don't feel comfortable talking about it in public. If you want to go into private, we can do that and come back out and talk about it.
Okay. I withdraw the concern. We'll talk about it later.
Any other questions? Seeing none, I'll close
Yes.
Mrs. DeLuna?
Yes.
Mr. Lord?
Yes.
Mr.
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. Mrs. Wagner, would you mind moving to operations?
Sure, if there are no objections, I would like to move items one under C1, transportation. We are approving the rescinding of the bid from October 22nd for bus 183. Then we are approving the rejection of the amount of the bid, and then we are approving the rebid sale of the bus 183.
Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Any questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. DeWolner?
Yes.
Mr. Moore?
Yes.
Mrs. Cass?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. All right, moving on to new business, no action being taken. Mr. Capello, would you mind moving to personnel?
Yes, absolutely. At our next meeting, I or someone very much like me will be moving into personnel. The items 1 through 4 below. Cashing vacation days, some part-time staff for emergency snow plowing expected in the next year, facilitating battle of books, and also we have 1, 2, 3, 4 aides that are all moving across the guide with their ADA certification. Congratulations to them. We also have the list of holidays for 12-1 staff. We're going to be amending the shared services agreement with the Township of Denver for our Class 3 special officers. And we're also going to be approving or voting to approve Stephen Forte for the district law enforcement liaison and Amy Farley as the district child welfare liaison for 2018-2019.
Second.
For item 1C, can we get not to exceed total added in for the next meeting?
I think it's 15 hours each.
Yes.
Right.
We could do the math. If you want that number?
I think it would be useful to have the total.
We just add in the total dollar.
Yeah, like the total dollar amount, just so it's obvious what we're, how much money we're putting out there.
Good.
Thank you.
And number 4 is just a cute second.
Any other questions? All right, Mr. Lewis, we're about to move to construction program. No action.
Sure. Next time we will be voting on the following items. We'll have a list of field trip requests. We'll have workshops with expenses. The only one we have on the list right now is for intervention and referral services training. We will have the next year's school calendar, the 2019-2020 school calendar. And we will also be voting to approve this year's district professional development plan.
Any questions on those items? All of us through policy. So at the next meeting, someone will be moving us through several policies that will be for second reading and adoption, and a couple for first reading. I believe some of these first readings I saw on instruction program, or one of the main meetings. Sorry, I can't remember.
Actually,
both. Okay. Anybody have any questions on the policy revisions?
I would just like to bring your attention to policy 5337, service animals. There was a change to it today. So if you happen to look at it prior to today, you should look at it again before we vote out on December 10th for a final reading. It was a
It's one of those things that are being dictated by case law, and that our attorney, the case was just settled, our attorney asked me to add a couple things in there that she thought was very important. And the reason why we're approving a non-mandatory policy is because we have, we do think that we're gonna have an instance of this coming up in the schools, we might have our policy on that.
Any other questions on policy? Mrs. Gulliver, would you want to go to finance?
Sure, at the next meeting, we have three items listed on the agenda. For vote would be the monthly checks, the IDEA application for FY 2019, and the accepting of revised grant award for the ESEA NCLB application for next year. The following amounts is listed on the agenda.
Until the day before or the day of.
No,
if we have been made aware of any issues where people are waiting and holding like a large number of grades and putting them in at the end, we have, you know, we've contacted those staff members and discussed with them. If we're aware of those kinds of issues that come up.
Okay, thank you.
I would imagine that's hard to police without input from parents that have a concern about our aid.
It is, because I can't necessarily, I can go on to homework every day.
Yeah.
But I can't necessarily, you know, it's just random grade books and stuff.
You're going on to every teacher's homework every day.
Well, I'm not going to, we do sample. We do sample, we just pick a couple to just check. And I have to say, they've been, you know, within 2 weeks when we implemented that procedure, it's been pretty solid. People have been pretty good about putting it up unless there was like a family emergency. But then it's just not due the next day. If you forget, and that doesn't happen very often, it just can't be due, you know, for a grade. And then you make it due the next day or something like that.
For the principals to spot check that periodically?
Yes.
And the vice principals?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay.
Even though I go on it, spot checking.
Yeah.
Since it's kind of pushed that procedure, I just like to check to make sure that it's getting out there.
Okay, thank you very much.
I guess the only other way to make it a little more user friendly to verify that's being done is if Genesis had a way to say this was the test date, and then Genesis would automatically, you know what I'm saying? If it was, but I don't know if Genesis has that capability to be able to, because then you would know right away that if it was the lag time was 21 days, then you know they're outside of.
And you'll notice that some people put in like a lot of assignments, but there's no grades yet. Like they just say, okay, these are all my assignments for the next however month. And then they just put the grades in as they go. And other people, it's just like as they're grading. They don't even put it up until they're grading it and then putting it in.
Yeah.
So that is kind of, but it's definitely a procedure to look at. Because
yeah.
I think that we've really tightened up on the homework. It's always something, you know, almost all of our middle school staff is using Google Classroom. And it's really a direction we're going, which is, way easier to follow.
So they're using Google Classroom to post grades to, or?
It's posting their assignments.
Yeah.
It's posting their
okay.
assignments. Grades are only in Genesis at this point, but there's a lot of linkage now that we could do.
Okay.
Because you graded one, you can automatically go to Genesis.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see. I would imagine that the question that Don asked comes up all the time for Genesis, being like one of the largest in the state. So it'd be interesting to see if you could put in the test date and then you would automatically know the date it's posted and be able to kind of, then you can almost run a report and see if there's any, I think we're good most of the time, but it's nice to be able to look at it without you or Mr. Andapaska or Mr. Ford say, going in and spot check, maybe that's.
And I'll
look into
that, you know, they do have that. There's the amazing things in Genesis that we learn all the time, and
yeah.
its capabilities, because it's just quite powerful. I think the one question we get the most is if, or get concerns, is if a teacher waits and holds them until the end. Because then you think your child is getting an A plus until the last day, and now it's a C. So that, and that's completely, negates the whole purpose of parents checking.
Sure.
But we also have, if you can monitor how many times a parent checks, and you'll get people that check 10 times a day, and it isn't that, it doesn't get updated now.
Yeah,
there's quite a range, from zero to literally hundreds and hundreds in that quarter.
It's
quite a range.
It's funny to watch the Facebook pages when it's report card day. It says report card day. It's 8:16. Well, I thought it was report card 8:15.
I don't understand.
Ancient programs it to be a certain time.
Oh, yeah, for
you're like, oh, yes. Okay.
I would say is that how I know it's report card day, not because I know, because my phone starts going.
Do you know what that's supposed to
be? Any other discussion items? I know that at the B&G committee, I know there was discussion on the Valley View Field, which Mr. Katz brought up, I think, at the last meeting. So I think we're discussing that in committee, correct?
Yes. We're still working on that.
If I may,
please.
We have a board goal of, what is it, to create and implement a community relations program. And when we looked at that goal, we talked about some items that we might want to discuss or plan for growth, fair funding. Maybe we also mentioned the budget, and some things came up tonight in the executive session that we, when we decide to get the public involved, would be a good way to get information out. And we don't know, I think we discussed this when it came up. We don't want to increase the work of the administration, but do we as a board, let's say we were going to have a newsletter or some type of monthly highlight in addition to the minutes or the agenda, things that we really kind of highlighting. I just don't know how, without giving them more jobs to do, we would go about that. It's our goal, not their goal.
Yep. Yep. Good question, and I appreciate you bringing it up. Why don't I do this? If you guys have ideas, think about it, send it over to me. I'll take that on to at least come up with some ideas and discuss it at the next meeting. I agree, I don't want to put that on the administration. I mean, certainly they can help and support a little bit, but I think it should be driven by us. And I know we've talked about it quite a bit for years, and we even talked, I mean, there's, I'll talk to school board, see if they have any ideas, and just let's start talking about it. I don't know off the top of my head exactly what that format should look like. And I think it's something just like the communication that the district does, that it's constantly like evolving. What works now is not gonna work maybe next year or 2 years from now, but let's see if we can come up with something that works now. And I know even like the Friday folders, I know the Forte redid them at least once or twice now. And it seems like every once in a while you got to kind of redo it to get interest again. So
that might be an option. Have a like a guest, a board member guest column or something, quarter or something. Well, I mean, we rotate each week. There's a new school. We highlight value one week. We highlight value Lakeview the next. And so on. Maybe like a closing word article in there. Like, by the way, you know, school funding or something that, you know,
yep.
Maybe we're not really touching on as much, especially like a political issue or something. Maybe that would be a bad way to get it. Sure. And then we also Facebook that and tweet that too.
Yep.
Steve, I don't know if you've done stats recently, but have you noticed since you started Facebook and not Twitter, that's older, but in sending out Friday folders, are you getting more clicks on that? Or
we get when I put it out on Facebook, it gets on Facebook alone, not that really only maybe 200 clicks from that, and then it goes to about 4,000 email addresses, and it has approximately half the people open it. Just open it though.
Yeah.
It doesn't necessarily mean they read the whole thing.
Okay.
They open it. The newsletter thing works a little better than the old way where it was just a bunch of documents. Now, like, you can kind of read through the Friday folder and just see, you know, the highlights.
Yeah, that is much easier.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I wonder if there's a way, I don't remember the first time I did, but I guess I could ask her to look back and see if there was an increase. I can tell how many people look at it on Facebook. So it's like 200 each time I put it up, which is not a ton, obviously. But we can try that. I'll see if somebody can find out that.
Just remember, Facebook is not the be-all, end-all of communication with the public.
Well, that's why I was asking to see if being on Facebook had in fact changed the rates.
Yeah. So send me ideas that you guys have. I know we've tried all sorts of stuff in the past from the, what was the newsletter called that you used to send out here? We did that for a while. You know, we've obviously increased our, you know, media coverage, Twitter, Facebook, email,
YouTube channel.
YouTube channel, yeah. I mean, be interested to see if that over to me, and then I'll kind of distribute what ideas we get consolidated. Thanks. Any other discussion items, comments, questions?
Last year, we had to shift the reorg meeting to January 1st. I noticed this year it's about as late as it can be, right?
Correct.
Is there going to be any issues with that this year for anybody?
That's the first Monday available.
Yeah.
We run the whole meeting, and that is the last day to hold the reorg meeting for this time of year. They gave us three additional days in case we didn't have a quorum for that seventh day. They'll give us an additional 3 days to fill our applications for reorg. So this baseball store there, we have to move the next few days.
I guess the question like last year is, anybody planning on being away?
Yeah, that was mainly what I was concerned about.
Seven school day.
The reason was, it's going to be like the second or the third.
Right.
It's going to be the third, I think, after vacation.
Have to be done with the first 7 days of the year.
Or you could be like another district locally that's up the street that always pushes it and then does it with their compliant meeting.
Yeah, apparently it doesn't consider it an issue. See, they even told us that.
Yeah, like, why are you doing this?
Yeah, you don't have to do this.
So we have it set for a regular work session meeting and reorg on the 7th.
Okay. But we're not pushing it beyond what's
allowed.
Beyond.
But we remember that even last year, remember there was something that was pressing I had to do on the 1st?
Yeah.
I don't remember exactly what it was, but we closed the reorg meeting and then we got a regular agenda. It was like one or two items.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's okay.
And will we, I'm guessing pretty soon we'll be looking at our meeting calendar, board of meeting?
That'll be approved.
Okay.
It's basically, we're going to stick with the same thing unless the board wants to change it.
Is somebody done? Will we approve it?
One extra month this year on one meeting, right, in September. I feel like we used to do two meetings.
Well, it's no happens that
which golf fund?
It's the golf outing.
Yeah.
Is the calendar?
It's the golf outing and Labor Day. Just,
yes.
Is the calendar in the chair?
We didn't do it yet. You have it? You want to put it? Well, I'll put it out to you as a sheet. Time to hit him up, I would say. Not smiling, because I know he.
Yeah, I've seen him at the playground dedication.
Yeah. He was at the Lakeview Veterans Day, too.
Yeah.
The
center of the
yeah.
I don't know if the center is there. I know I saw the others. Yeah. Yeah, they are making an appearance.
They all made a picture of the
playground dedication. Good time to hear any questions.
Which I heard about. But they were there for a while.
You were there. Weren't you in the background of the picture?
The context was they were there for the photo op, not having nothing to
I'm wondering how you got shoved to the back, Tom.
Well, I told, one of the town councilmen told me, you know, they said, Don, you got to, this, you got to get the pictures for the dignitaries. I said, my, my sixth grade teacher must be rolling over in her bed, Don cast an out.
Speaking of the Lakeview Veterans Day ceremony, I just wanted to thank the administration for continuing to support that program. I know we had it at, I think, all three schools, we had some sort of event. I unfortunately couldn't make Riverview because it was almost back to back, so I was only at the Lakeview event. And the one thing I will say is that I went to six classrooms after the auditorium presentation, and I was so impressed with the questions they asked, the engagement. I know when we had our strategic planning, we talked about, you know, beyond just the curriculum and teaching students about being well-rounded and citizenship. And it is unbelievable the way that teachers immediately stopped everything and the students were engaged immediately, and a lot of them had questions already kind of written out. And, I mean, just the engagement and the questions they had were well beyond anything I thought of in first, third, fifth grade. So, and I was in kindergarten all the way through fourth grade classrooms, and like I said, just really impressed with obviously the program, but more impressed even when I went to the classrooms and sat with the students to talk to them. It was another great event, and I appreciate that we're doing it across the different schools. Tom was there too.
Great event.
25 years, so it's great.
It was a nice addition at Valley View, so today we had a number of people come to speak to the students today, and they were talking about how when the word gets out, more people will want to come in and speak. So.
I had one other thing I forgot to mention on my report was, if you saw in this last report, I put an update on one of my merit goals, which I did complete, and it's on for approval on the 26th. It was, did get certified as an observer, which was timely because I need to do some observations on the pew, right? And it was a little challenging. It took a while, and then actually my first attempt wasn't successful, but the second attempt I ran out of that. Yeah. So it was pretty tough.
You should be given a paw for perseverance.
That's right.
Yeah, I definitely need that.
Well, dang it, I was giving my paw. It is way harder. And then they block you if you don't, and you have to like go back and do training for a month, and then you get to do it again. Yes. Okay. So it's not a joke. Yes, it's intense. But now every one of our observers is certified.
Any other good cause comments? It is 8:30. I'm open for open public comment section. No public, I will close at 8:30. No need for a second executive.
I don't have